So, what is the phrase man says?
Yeah.
What is the phrase man says when man have a muta marriage right. with the woman from 3 o'clock to 5 o'clock?
Okay. If the woman knows Arabic language, then she has to say it the Arabic language.
What is it?
She says to you, I marry myself to you for a dowry of X, like £1,000, whatever. Dowry of X for a number of days of X. Then you say, قبلت الزواج. So in Arabic, she says to you, زوجتك نفسي على مهر فلان لمدة فلان. And then you say, قبلت الزواج. I accept the marriage. And then she becomes your wife. And this is what she says.
So,
but there's rules to it.
Just a moment. You have the marriage
yeah.
from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock.
You're giving me an example. Are you giving me an example?
So I'm giving you an example.
Okay.
I'm just trying to understand.
Okay.
You have the marriage from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock. And
then
you are paying her
yeah.
£4,000.
No, no. I'm
just
saying,
one.
No, no.
Sir,
you can give her anything.
Sir,
it doesn't have
one.
To be money.
That's what you discussed.
Yeah.
She is happy with the 1,000. You are happy too with the 1,000. Okay?
Okay, yeah. It's an agreement.
That's what you agree?
Yeah.
Do you need any witnesses for that marriage?
No, you do not need any witnesses for this marriage.
So you don't need any witnesses?
No.
So, the Muslim woman, she was over there. You can simply go to her and then say, I want to have a muta marriage and you don't need to go to mosque, you don't need to get any witnesses. Correct?
Correct. However, if she's never been married before and she's still like virgin and that, then you have to get the permission from her father.
Okay.
But if she's been divorced, then you do not need her father's permission because it's in her own hands.
Okay. So, if she's virgin,
if her father is dead, you have to get her grandfather's permission.
She has to be a virgin.
No, if she's not virgin.
So, let's say she's not a virgin.
Yeah,
okay?
Like she's been divorced.
So you,
she's been divorced. Because if she's not a virgin in a haram way and she's still under her dad's permission.
Can you not
no,
speak?
She has to be divorced.
Sir,
sorry. Yeah.
I really want to understand
yeah.
the wisdom of Allah in this.
No, no.
I titled it as a prostitution.
No, no, no.
But
if
you are not going to listen to no, I haven't brought my
no,
question
you said,
to you yet.
But it's not clear.
I haven't yeah. Listen.
I'm saying if she's a virgin, if she's lost her virginity through haram way, then you still have to get her father's permission. But if she's been divorced, then you do not. If she's been married and then divorced, then you do not need her father's permission.
Now listen my question very carefully, okay?
Yeah.
I seriously want to know the practical side of it. Therefore, I am asking.
Why you want to know?
Get on the line. I'll talk to you.
Yeah. No. Why you want to know everything about this?
So, woman, girl, she's virgin, okay? You go to her father and then say, your virgin daughter, she's only 9 years old.
No. What do I need? No. Hold on. Wait. Why are you
talking to the wrong Muslim?
No. 9 years old.
Just a moment.
You mean no. It's not allowed.
Sir,
9 years old. Why are you saying 9 years old? No. Why are you saying 9 years old? No. You're not allowed. What's
19?
No. The allowed age is 18. The allowed age is 18.
18. According to whom?
Of course,
she's talking about Aisha.
I'm not talking about Aisha.
Yes,
you
are. Why you mention 9 years old? Why you mention 9 years old?
Aisha was 18, not 9.
18 when she was married. 18. We have a fax.
It's not a fake cleric. I know. I heard it on the radio. It's a fake. It's fake.
In here, your guy.
It's fake. It's fake.
Can you
it's fake.
9 years old plus.
No,
there is no problem at all.
That's not true.
According to Sharia,
no.
There is no problem.
No,
do what you desire. Says the clashing Sayyid Mustafa.
This is fabricated. This is fabricated.
Just one. You said as soon as girl is the virgin, you need to go to the father to get the permission.
She can be virgin. Are you a virgin?
You
can be a 50 years old virgin. It doesn't have to be 9 years old. So you're trying to say after 9 years old they lose their virginity? There's girls 20 they're virgin. There's 30 they're virgin.
The priest not allowed to get married. You know that. The priest not allowed to get married.
But with your fish hair, I thought you would bring your brain to speakers.
But in Christianity, the priest not allowed to get married. Is that right or no?
Bring your ears together.
Is that right?
I am seriously trying to question the prostitution under the
What prostitution? How is it prostitution?
So, therefore,
it's marriage.
You are not allowing me to speak. Therefore, I cannot make my case. It is prostitution. It is prostitution.
On what basis are you saying it's prostitution?
For the prostitution, do you need to go and get the permission from the woman's family or man's family? No. For the mutah marriage. For the mutah marriage. Do you need to go and get the permission from the her family?
Yes, it's a contract.
Listen.
It's a contract.
No, you can make. He said already knows that one.
Yes, you do. You do.
Unless she's virgin.
No.
You said unless she's virgin.
No.
If she's not virgin, you do not need.
She has to be a virgin when you put her. What that means? The woman has to be a virgin, not married.
No,
so
no.
A woman has to be virgin.
No, virgin, yes.
No,
so for the virgin woman, you can run
the
city.
No,
no.
How much do you pay?
I don't pay nothing.
No. No.
So you just have a sex free?
No.
You have a place, you pay,
Dowry is Hindu. Dowry is Hindu, babe.
Is it Hindu?
You have a sex free?
Dowry is Hindu.
No sex free. In the contract, it is an Islamic way.
How much do you pay?
The Quran says...
How much do you pay?
In Quran is mentioned. Tamatta'u nisa.
That's my question.
It is a Quran.
How much do you pay for the mutamad?
I don't pay nothing. It's a contract. It's an Islamic way. It's an Islamic halal way.
Yeah.
I don't pay nothing.
Why in Surah 4 verse 24 talks about payday your wages for the pleasure you receive from the sexual relationship, you go against the Quran?
Go look at your Catholic priest who never get married. Why the priest doesn't get married?
I'm talking about the prostitution Allah labeled as the muta nikah. So I am asking the simple question. How many times did you have a muta? Did you have a muta?
It's not for this guy. Why are you talking about Sunni people?
Just a moment.
Sunnis don't practice.
Just a moment. This Surah 4 verse 24, not in the Quran.
All right. Which day is today?
Do you use different Quran?
Which day is today? Sunday.
Then listen,
Sunday. What day is supposed to be? You're supposed to be in the church.
Do you use different
You're supposed to be in church.
We don't use different Quran. Quran is
what you preach. Are you recording for her?
I'm simply asking the question, which Allah, with all of his wisdom, with all of his mercy, titles as a temporary marriage, which is nikah muta, which means you marry with someone from 2 o'clock to 5 o'clock, and then you pay for the pleasure you receive from sex.
Explain
and then both of you goes to your own way. I think that is ugly. I think that is disgusting. And today it is identified as the prostitution.
Explain to us your religion.
I'm just trying to justify that. Isn't that shame? That's very shame. Here's the alternative for you people.
Shame for what?
We don't believe that.
God made Adam and Eve for one another.
I clean myself 5 times a day, you know that.
Until death parts them. Yet Muslim thinks that's very funny for them to just go
and... Because he's talking bullshit. Every single week. Every talk about your religion.
So why they identified Quran is what is not bullshit.
Talk about your religion.
Muslims are calling their Quran bullshit.
You trying to attack
Muslim
Islam.
Friends are practicing that so-called bullshit.
That's easy. They say you. Let me explain to you.
Prostitution. People, keep yourself away from Islam. Prostitution is ugly. And when Islam steps in and then gives that as the divine law of Allah, still it is ugly.
You don't believe Allah. What are you talking about?